Hello and welcome to this episode of Ask the Expert. My name is Lucas and I'm part of the Smart Factory Consulting team. Today I would like to show you two typical situations we see very often during our customer projects, which lead to non-value-adding loss of time, affect the efficiency of the overall process, and in the worst case, even cause machine downtimes. What you can see right here next to me are pallets with unprocessed sheets. So you might ask yourself now, what's special, what's problematic about them? Well, let's have a closer look at the pallets. Pallets with different types of sheets or different materials are stapled on top of each other. This is problematic because if you want to process the sheets below, you must remove firstly all the other sheets, and afterwards the material needs to be restacked. This costs time that cannot be used for other more value-adding tasks. A first improvement can be made by establishing a rule that prohibits stacking different materials on top of each other. However, in our experience, a rule alone will not do the trick. That is why we always recommend to implement additional organizational measures. If the storage system is manual, each individual compartment should be labeled with the name of the stored material. If the material is stored on pallets on the floor, as you can see it here, dedicated areas should be marked on the ground for each type of material. But to maintain order in the warehouse in the long term, it is recommended to discuss incorrectly stored material within the shop floor management or team meeting. All right, let me show you another situation that we face often at customer sites that can be handled more efficient. Now I'm standing next to a storage filled with laser cut parts that will be bent next. Because the storage is full, someone just placed the newest pallet with laser cut parts right in front of it. This situation can end typically in two different ways. Sometimes the pallet on the ground is pushed aside to get the correct parts. This is inefficient and can directly affect the productivity of the bending machines. Other times, these parts that are easiest to reach are selected first instead of those which should be produced next according to the delivery date of the production plan. This can lead to delays in agreed delivery times of the initially foreseen parts. A proven solution to avoid this is to mark the floor area that must always remain free. In addition, it is recommended to designate a specific area as a backup storage for those times when the initially assigned storage is already full. Factories with space limitations might require additional measures to ensure that the machine productivity doesn't suffer from increased material handling. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to our Smart Factory Consulting team. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and please leave your comments. Thanks for watching this episode of Ask the Expert. See you next time.